Before we get to the main topic, let's summarize a few things first, okay? Here, I will start by summarizing four things, namely the Akasha, Akasha system, Akasha terminal, and the current situation of the Akasha system. Then, we continue to the speculation section, okay? If it is okay, let's move on. The Akasha is an open digital library technology that can be accessed by everyone in Sumeru as a form of freedom of knowledge there, which was first created and developed by Greater Lord Urgadevata. Akasha system is the result of real implementation of the Akasha. The Akasha system used the Ilmin Soul Tree as its information storage and is powered by Dendrogenesis. According to information we know so far up to version 2.0, the remaining quote-unquote consciousness of Greater Lord Urgadevata is quote-unquote stored in the Ilmin Soul Tree, which is connected to the Akasha system. Akasha terminal, well, is a device used to access the Akasha system, shaped like an earpiece, or we often call it like Dendro port, the Sumerian version of the airport. After Greater Lord Urgadevata died or disappeared, the Akasha system was then continued by the Academia. Under the Academia control, the Akasha system is known to have several changes. Initially, the Akasha system was only accessible to travelers and students who had plans to stay long in Sumeru City. However, this regulation changed to that every travelers who entered Sumeru City will be given Akasha terminal and have access to the Akasha system. There are two locations in Sumeru which are the best place to access this Akasha system, namely Sumeru City and Port Ormos. Okay, enough talking about that general info. Let's move on to the speculation about the Akasha and the Academia and also their dark secret. First thing first, the important question that need to be asked at this time is that how can the Academia run the Akasha system at this time? We need to remember beforehand that the Akasha system is powered by Genosis, right? Which, as far as I know, the power of Genosis can be only used by Archon or puppets that are specifically designed to take over the power of Genosis. So, if that the case, the only way for the Academia to continue the Akasha system is by creating a special puppet or finding a new Dendro Archon. So, here's my speculation, or you could say like a mini theory. Right after Greater Lord Urgadevata disappear or die, the Academia immediately decided to find a replacement for Dendro Archon, and finally Kusanali was found. For now, I don't know how they can magically found her, but let's ignore that for a moment. Kusanali's discovery was really welcomed by the Academia, but not in order to celebrate the new Dendro Archon, but as a tool that can be used to continue the Akasha system. Because with Kusanali, the Academia didn't have to worry about how to harness the power of Genosis. But here's the thing. When it was first found, Kusanali was still in a newborn state, so it could be said that she was completely powerless at that time. This could have been used by the Academia and forced Kusanali to use her Genosis. Do you still remember this dialogue? The sages later found the newly born Dendro Archon and whisked her back to Sumeru. By using the word whisk, it means must be brought as soon as possible. This shows that at that time, the Academia really needed Kusanali to be able to run the Akasha system again. I don't want to talk about this, but I found something weird now. Here's the question. How does the Academia force the newly born Kusanali to use Genosis? Well, to answer this question, let's take a good look at the place where Kusanali is said to be, namely the Sanctuary of Surasthana. If you look at it, Sanctuary of Surasthana, there's something odd about that place. Based on the description in the game, it said, the palace located at the top of Sumeru City, It is believed to be the residence of the current Dendo Archon, Lesser Lord Kusanali. No one apart from the sages of the Academia has ever seen this deity with their own eyes for the last few hundred years. You might think that this sanctuary of Surasthana is a prison, or the place where Kusanali is locked up. But for me, that place is more than just a prison. Well, how I put this? Personally, I speculate that the sanctuary of Surasthana is a place where Kusanali is forced to use Genosis and is harnessed for its power just like energy generator. Or maybe looks like this, like this picture. Not very accurate, but you can imagine it like a tube, like artificial womb. My speculation is also supported by the dialogue that Kusanali said at the end of Sumeru Archon Quest Act 2, when Kusanali controlled Catherine's body. Kusanali there mentioned that she is the first Akasha Terminal. Yes, you didn't hear me wrong. She said the first Akasha Terminal. So, what does that mean? Well, what if I told you that Kusanali is probably the center of this Akasha system, as well as a tool that power ups the whole system? And one more addition. My suspicions increase at night time, which when view this sanctuary of Surasthana seems to be sucking something up so that it emits a very bright green light at night time. Well, it could be just my over observation, but still it could be true. To be honest, after I explain all of that, it sounds more terrifying than just a prison, right? This also answers the question why no one ever sees Kusanali in the past few years. It is because the Academia doesn't want people to know about this dark secret. Also, to make it more convincing, the Academia spread misinformation among scholars and people of Sumeru that less knowing about Kusanali is not that bad. This is proven in the Sumeru Archon Quest this time, where all the scholars and residents of Sumeru do not really care about Kusanali, or you can say that they are not curious about Kusanali's presence. Not being able to see Lesser Lord Kusanali may not be a bad thing, or if the Akasha system tells you shouldn't know, so why should I? So that is the Academia's propaganda. But if you think the Academia's actions stop here, you are totally wrong. They still have other propagandas and plans that are more dirtier than this. Since I have talked too much here, let's talk about their other plans and propaganda in part 2. So, if you enjoyed this video, click the like button and don't forget to subscribe for more content in the future. Also, share your thought and speculation in the comment section down below. Hello Zen here, and see you next time. Bye.